Water is at the heart of everything on Long Island. It is critical to our health and our quality of life. The water that we drink is beneath our feet. The water that sustains our multi-billion dollar tourism industry and is central to our quality of life surrounds us. And in the wake of Sandy, we understand that water can also be a threat to us. I recently released a report conducted by our experts in the health department, which demonstrated that we have been polluting this precious resource in a way that has devastated our surface waters, our river corridors, our bays, caused declining trends in the quality of our drinking water, and made us more vulnerable to future storms like Sandy. The primary cause of this significant decline in water quality is nitrogen. Nitrogen is public water enemy number one. For years, we've seen the impacts of this increased nitrogen pollution. Harmful algal blooms, closed beaches, brown tide, and the decimation of an iconic Long Island industry. Just 30 years ago, more than half the clams eaten in the United States came out of the Great South Bay, fueling an industry that employed more than 6,000 people. And today, it's all gone. And the cause? Nitrogen pollution. We must use the best science to establish priorities and then work community by community, neighborhood by neighborhood, house by house. We must all take responsibility to reclaim our water together.